What's up guys, Don Juan here. So before I start this video, I wanted to share with you guys some information, share with you guys some good news. So I'm actually buying a house. So it was kind of spare the moment, weird situation. If some of you guys remember, this house that I currently live in, it does not belong to me. My father was nice enough to let me rent this place from him at a cost that I could afford because this is a larger house that I cannot afford. I was planning to buy a house next year, but I like to keep my eye on the market to see if any good deals came up. So long story short, I found a house down the street from here. It's literally closer to my job than I already live, and I live super close to my job. So it's down the street in another neighborhood. It was a repoed house that is a really good deal. That neighborhood sells for in the 120 range or something like that, and you know, some of the bigger houses sell for more, and I'm getting a house for like 100, you know, or something like that. So I was kind of spared a moment. We really liked the house. It's a smaller house, so it's easier for us to maintain. And if a lot of you guys remember, some of the stuff in this house that in my old videos where it looked like there was like pile, the boxes stacked behind me, are not mine either. So it'll be a little bit easier to set up. So with that being said, the mods on the scat are gonna slow down a little bit. Basically what I was planning to do next was probably some long tube headers or maybe a few other things, but I decided obviously against that, you know, need down payment money and some other stuff. You know, we're gonna be painting the house and doing stuff. So when that goes through, which is gonna be, it's a little bit, a while from now, since it's a foreclosed house, if you guys aren't aware, it takes a little bit longer to close. So but when I go and start doing all that, I will be taking you guys along to, you know, the whole thing. I get to finally actually set up the garage, my own garage, the way I want to. We're going to be epoxying the floor. We're going to be doing some painting and stuff. So I'm going to bring you guys with me throughout the whole process, and hopefully you guys enjoy it just as much as I do. But I wanted to share that with you guys just in case if you guys don't see too many modifications going on the scat. Like I said, possible sometime in a few months kind of mods. Like I said, I wanted to do some long tubes here soon. That was like my next big mod I wanted to do. There might be a few little things here and there, depending on what the prices are. I know I still haven't showed you guys the full camo video. That video I'm still working on, so you know, I have to get it edited and all that stuff, and there's actually a few pieces I have to redo, so I'll talk to you guys in a different video. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that like button. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace. What we're gonna be doing is the oil change on Luna. I just broke 6,000 miles. People think you should take the original oil, the break-in oil, what people like to call it, assembly oil, out of the car right away. Some people do it at 500 miles, some people do it at 1,000 miles. I was planning to do it, got sidetracked, got really close to, like, I was at like 4,800 miles or 5,000 miles, and I was like, you know what, I mean, whatever you believe. If you want to do it at 500 or 1,000 miles and then do it again, some people like to do that, or if you like to do it, what I'm planning to do is I'm going to do it right now at 6,000. I'm going to do it again at 12,000. I'm going to do the full 6,000 mile increment, and then I'm going to send off an oil analysis to Blackstone, I believe is what they're called, and then they'll let you know if the oil still has more life left in it or if you need to cut it down a little bit. Since with the Texas heat and everything, I'm going to see if I might have to bring it down to like every 5,000 or something, but we'll see. But what you're going to need to do this is 7 quarts, a whole case, and 1 quart of Pennzoil Platinum, Ultra Platinum, I'm sorry, 040, and it says actually on there, SRT on the bottom right there. These are the new bottles right here, if I remember correctly. The gray ones, or these are the old ones or something like that, and the yellow ones are the new ones, I can't really remember. But anyway, so you're gonna need 7 quarts, and then you're gonna need an oil filter, obviously. Shout out to Steve White, who sent me a few. So the other items you're gonna need is a ratchet, a 10 millimeter socket and an extension, a filter removal wrench, and a 13 millimeter socket or wrench.
All right guys, so we got the car jacked up. So that'll show you right there. And basically you're gonna jack it up, and then let me see if I can get this so you guys can see. There goes the jack stand. And you see I have it on the frame right there. Show you guys what happens when you ride a little too low. So let's go underneath here. Ugh.
So you can see right here, this is one spot that I rub on sometimes. Right here, you can see it's kind of bended back a little bit and it has some scratches on it. The bumper's fine. Here's the bumper. I'll show you guys the bumper. The bumper's fine all the way down, no issues. I know I wasn't rubbing there, but right here, you can see, there's some right there. There's some right there on this little knobby, the other little piece you can see. So pretty much it's just the plastics that are underneath the car.
Right here, as you can see, is our drain plug. So we're gonna remove that. I believe it's like a 13, but I'll let you know for sure. That's gonna drain our oil. And then right here on this side, it's kind of hard to see, but that is your oil filter. So basically you're gonna drain this and drain this, put the new filter on, fill the bad boy up with oil, and then you'll be good to go.
You have your new filter here. What you're gonna do is you're gonna fill it with fresh oil. You don't wanna put a filter on dry. Even if you can't get all the way full, like some cars is kinda at an angle, even if you can't get it all the way full, a little oil in there is better than no oil. So we're gonna, this one's straight up, so we're gonna fill it pretty much all the way. That should be good enough. So now I'm gonna cap this. I guess we have some more space. Oops. And then you want to take some of the fresh oil, put it around the seal, so that when you put it on there, you get a nice good seal. Thank you.
Oh wow, guys. Wait until you see this. So, we put this on when the car had about, what would you say, like 3,000 miles on it, 2,500 miles on it, something like that, because I didn't order it right away. And wait until you see this. So this is about only half of an oil change. Oh, look at that. That is about halfway full. I'm gonna pour it out so you guys can take a look. So all of that would have been in your intake and in where your valves are at and everything, and caked them all up. So that's all that ring blow by that these things are known for. So yeah, make sure you get a catch can, guys, because this thing is gonna save your motor from a lot of potential damage. So guys, that's how you do an oil change on a 2015 to 2018 Dodge Charger, Challenger, pretty much 300, anything on the same chassis. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hopefully you guys can do this kind of stuff yourself, because this is the kind of stuff that will save you a lot of money. Doing oil changes yourself, doing tranny flushes yourself, doing, we used to call them gravy money when I was in this stuff. So it's stuff that takes a little bit of time, a little bit of effort, but it's super easy to do, and that they make the most money on them. So as the car needs maintenance further on, we're gonna be doing everything like I showed you in this video with the long tubes. When we get to that, it's gonna be a bitch to install, but it's gonna be well worth it. Hopefully you guys will stick with me through that process, and if you liked the video, don't forget to thumbs up, hit that subscribe button down below, and like always, keep it gangsta. Peace.